Well, it's sort of an embargo lift. Well, we can at least talk about the cards and take a look at them today. So you've already seen it unboxed. So what we want to do right quick before we actually get our hands all over these things and put fingerprints on them and get a good look at the cards in the flesh other than on stage and in renders. So these are both the 6800 series. So we've got the 6800 XT and the 6800, and both of these are packing the Navi 21 GPU, of course different configurations of that. However, they do both share the 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 on a 256-bit bus memory interface with the AMD Infinity Cache, and we'll get more into the Infinity Cache once the review is able to go live, and we'll talk about that a lot more in detail there. But for now, again, just a recap. So we want to look at the 6800 first. Now that is featuring 60 compute units for a total of 3,840 stream processors, all running at a game clock of 815 megahertz with just over 2,000 megahertz on the boost clock. Now, it also features 240 TMUs and 96 ROPs, with a total board power of 250 watts. Now, the 6800 XT comes in a little bit higher on, well, pretty much every specification. We've got 72 compute units comprising a total of 4,608 stream processors, clocked at a game clock of 2015 megahertz with over 2200 megahertz as the boost clock. Instead of a much lower 240 TMUs, we're looking here at 320, and instead of 96 ROPs, we got 128. And all of that comes at a little bit more of a price with a 300 watt total board power. Now, they are different sizes. The 6800 is a 2-slot, and the 6800 XT is a 2.5 slot. You know what? That's enough talking about the specs. Let's get our hands on the cards. Hey guys, so we got it out of the box. We got the speeds and the feeds kind of out of the way. What I figured with this time around we do is actually do a little bit more hands-on with the cards than just a, you know, here's the cards, here's what you get. We're going to kind of go around the card. I'd like to do a bit of a comparison to each other, you know, just kind of survey the card. Honestly, the biggest difference physically between these two cards is just the height. So this is the XT, it's a 2.5 slot, and the 6800 is a full-blown 2 slots. So you're gonna get, that's it, that's gonna be your difference. Otherwise they're functionally almost completely identical. So what we'll do for the sake of brevity here is we're gonna take the 6800 and we're gonna kind of set it to the side here. Now this logo is already red there. That should give you an idea of something. Whereas this one, it's nice and white. So other than that, you know, I mean, we'll go ahead and flip it over if you want to see the back side. The back plates are functionally the same, screws in the same location. So, you know, water blocks for all three, the 6800, 6800 XT, and probably the 6900 XT are probably all going to end up being the same. You got the triple fans with the reinforced speed rings on the outside. Now you get a little bit of a different accent here. So these have this little chrome piece here, and these have these much fatter chrome piece right there. If that is something that matters to you, I don't know how many people are really gonna care about that. Performance-wise, you're gonna have to wait for the review to see that one, so to see how differently they are, but fans are essentially the same. I'm gonna go ahead and set this one right here. We're gonna leave it just there. Now I did grab another graphics card just for a quick comparison to in size. This is the 5700 XT, and you see that it is actually slightly longer due to the little design there. And quite frankly, I'm glad to see they got away from the corduroy pants look of the old generation. There's, I guess, you know, they kind of hold on to a little bit of a dent, but let's kind of survey around the card. Let's take a look all the way around it. We're gonna start with the IO. So if I can keep the light from looking too crazy on there. So you've got your HDMI 2.1, you got your DisplayPort 1.4, you got two of those and a Type-C. Now they're not calling this a virtual link, but you know, there are some displays with Type-C connections and some, you know, VR headsets that will utilize that. And it is completely closed off here with the Radeon logo. So there is no heat going to be expelled out of the back of the card. I don't know if I can even talk about that right now, but it's fairly obvious. Let's go ahead and get the card a little bit closer so you can get a good look at the fans. Now again, they have the little reinforced ring on them. they got a good deep swell to them, so the good swoop, you know, so they scoop the air real good, not like the Radeon 7 that had very, you know, thin straight angle blades. These whip around real good. They've got the Team Rocket logo on there. Everybody likes that. And they got the nice little silver accent going around. I haven't taken the little protective thing off there because I wanted to keep that a little bit nice and clean. Now the back of it, of course, is, you know, it's uneventful. It's got the reinforcement plates. See, places like Dell will utilize those for mounting supports in cases for shipping and storage and all that jazz. And you can see there the 6800 is very similar. It's got kind of the same thing going on there. Again, I'm going to set that down right there because it's essentially the same, just not quite as thick. Not a whole lot going on over here. You've got the PCI Gen 4.0, and then you've got the heatsink going on. Now, something I wanted to see if we can get this on camera is the heatsink is actually going to be a full vapor chamber, and I can show you that without having heat pipes running all through it, which is kind of cool. I'm going to see if we can do this, if I can get it up here. You can see the light running. Might have to swoop it a little bit, but you can see all the way through it. That's really cool. I hope nobody gets mad that I did that. But I'm not going to be disassembling these cards. There's quite a bit to taking them apart, and I can't afford to break these, so we have to be able to use these for future efforts. There will be plenty of folks out there that will be more than happy to tear this to pieces. So that's kind of the card in itself. Again, let me grab the 5700 XT and we'll do it up against the 6800. I see that as I almost drop it. But there they are, right there, fairly similar in size. You can see, you know, kudos. I like what they've done with this. Well, there you go, guys. Those were the 6800 series. Now, if you followed this channel in the last few reviews that we did, we've been very hyper-focused on the video review. Now, for a written review, there's going to be probably 20, 21 pages worth of information, benchmarks. We did all kinds of benchmarks from ray tracing benchmarks, rasterized benchmarks, SAM, even though it's not technically supported on the motherboard that we used. But we'd love to hear what you guys want to see in that focused review. Remember, we're going for 5 to 7 minutes. We're going to keep it kind of short, sweet. Do you want to see 1440p results, ultra-wide 1440p results, 4K results? Do you only want to see ray tracing results, or do you want to see the difference that smart access memory makes on a motherboard that's technically not, you know, it's not on their list, but it clearly worked? Would you like to see those? And if you did want to see those, do you want to see 1440p, ultra wide 1440p, 4K, or you just want to see all of them? Let us know down in the comment section below, and we'll catch you guys here in a few days for the full review.